I'm ready to cut these barrels that I turned on the lathe down to length on the table saw. Don't ever, ever, ever try to cross cut a cylinder like this just by holding it with your hand. It's a prescription for getting this thing rolling and a kickback, or just turning your work into mush. So it has to be clamped, it has to be pinned, but it also has to be pinned to a backing that is at least as high as the center line of your piece. So I probably could have got away with pinning this one right here because it's narrow enough. I mean, the diameter is small enough that I could have pinned that there and made my cut. But I know this one is pushing it here. That's exactly, and so it could have lifted and not given me a secure clamp. So it's so simple. Just take a piece of scrap. So this is from another jig, and I'm just gonna cut this. It's already got the pre-drilled holes, and then I'm just gonna clamp it. I'm gonna screw it to this, and then I'll have a backing that I can pin this to, and then just reach over it with the hand screw and pin it down. So let me cut this guy down and screw it there, and then I'll come right back and we'll cut these guys to length safely and accurately. So now I got my piece of scrap screwed to the fence, and I always leave it overhanging a little bit and then cut it. So now I've got an exact place where I know where the blade, where I can put my line up to it. And so now I can put my hand screw here. I mean, again, this isn't rocket science we're doing here. This just needs to be cut uniformly and pretty accurate. Mosquito. But see, now there is no way that this barrel can spin on me while I'm trying to cut it. And since I've given myself this, now all I have to do is line up. I think I'll just finish that with the Japanese saw. I'm not going to risk it. So I'm just going to flip this guy. Line up my line with my cut. That's just an easy cut. Let me cut these other two, and then I'll just trim them all with the Japanese saw at once. So here's our liptus, our laminated liptus. Man, that's got some heft to it. That's going to be an awesome mallet there. This one will cut it all the way. Okay, well these guys now are ready. So the big one, I'm going to drill a hole in it using a jig on the drill press. And then this one and the Liptis one, I'm going to make a plunge cutting jig for the router, and I'm going to plunge all the way through and create a rectangular hole. Oh yeah, let me trim this end off with the Japanese saw. It's not bad. Nice and easy, let the saw do the work. Some pretty hard, dense stuff, this pecan. That one I got just perfect. That one has got just a little bit of a, you know, just a little bit of lip, but it's okay because I'm going to shape one side. It's going to be convex, and the other side's going to get touched easily on the belt sander, and then polished up. So this is ready to have the hole drilled in it now, and I'll drill the hole cross grain through it like this. All right, I'm ready to mark these barrels now, so I know center lines and orientation. And as I mentioned before, I want to drill my hole perpendicular to the annual ring, so I want my hole, I want my lines marked like this. And so I'll show you the best way that I know how to do this. I just put a hand screw and I put my small square in here, and I don't tighten it down, I just leave it kind of loose so I'm able to adjust it. And then I take my ruler with my dividing head. And first of all, I go ahead and I just eyeball it to where I'm bisecting as perpendicular as I can to those annual rings. I have my mechanical pencil and my grandpa reading glasses on, and I've kind of sharpened the pencil up a little bit, and I try to just do it in one line. Then I bring this up and I let that touch. That's a pretty good start right there. So now I've got that line. Now I can set it back up here again. Line that line up to this. You can see I'm off a little bit, but it's going to be close enough. I mean, you're talking probably, oh, just a quarter of a degree or something, and there's just always a fudge factor doing stuff like this. Now I'll line this guy up again to the line that I just drew. Kind of complete the lines here across that shoulder. That looks right on. That looks right on. Perfect. Pretty darn good. Perfect. So now I've got, now then the next thing I'll do is I'll determine exactly halfway, and I'll use that with my combination square. But let me go ahead and mark these other two out. And again, so here's the annual rings running this way. So I want to mortise my hole perpendicular to this. So I'm going to put my dividing head to where I just get it as perpendicular as possible. bring that up and get it close already. See, if you had that too tight in that hand screw, you may not be able to just get that nice final adjustment. Perfect. Down here. Good. Hard to improve on that. So let me find center lines. And then we'll start making some holes through them. All right, let me just put my marks on here now. So I'm an American, and I think and use imperial inches and feet all the time. But I also use the metric system because it just is so much easier to make calculations like this. So I've got my metric ruler and my Mitutoyo combination square. I just put this guy down. I see that it's 15.6, that I know immediately that that's 7.8 is the split. Instead of having to do a bunch of fractions calculations, which I can do them, but why bother? I think this just keeps from making mistakes. So that just, you know, that's just perfect on the first try that I got it. I always mark from both sides, so if there is a little bit of a split, then I can just choose the middle spot. And so let's do this one now. You know what? I'm making a mistake here. I should not be measuring from the ends, but I should be centering this off of the shoulder. That's what I should be doing. So let me see if that's gonna be the same here, if I need to redo that. So that's 11.2, that would be 5.6. It's perfect, that's perfect. But I'm gonna measure this one from the middle here. I'm gonna say that this is 18.3, so that's 9.15. And then I'm just going to put my square to that. Give myself a little bit better line and go ahead and measure it off the same side, not flip it in case there is a little bit of a variation. So that's that. And that's 15.8. So that would be 7.5 plus 4, 17.9, 7.9. Perfect. Go ahead and do the same thing again. Bring this up. There we go. I'll just peen these with a scratch awl, make a mark in it.